I sing because I'm happy, and I sing because I'm free.
Welcome back to Magic Tarot Cards. It's Jasmine. I have a 6-card spread here for you. This is going to be about a person named Justin Evans. He's 22 years old and he was missing. He came missing on December 12th of 2020, not that long ago, from a place called Killingsworthy in Canada. I believe it's in Canada. Someone made me aware of this story. I did go watch maybe it was like a 5-minute clip on him so I could pick up his energy. He has not been found, and there really isn't any suspects yet, but I do believe there is foul play, and I'm going to give you the truth today. I meditated on this with spirit, and I believe I already know the truth. So I'm going to give that to you today. Don't forget, this video is not made for kids. If you're under the age of 18, please click off now. This channel is my brand. Do not attempt to copy it for any reason. Y'all, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Give me a thumbs up and hit that notification bell so you'll be reminded when I upload another video. Y'all, this is my new tarot card deck. The same one I've been using, but I just ordered a new deck because the other ones I've had for over 20 years. They were like really dirty. This is my old one here. I keep it in this box. I am going to still be using it when I do tarot card readings, but when I do my videos, I'll be using the new deck. I do not want to get rid of these because they hold a lot of energy, and I just want to keep them, okay? So, and then again, here is my cup that I'm drinking my magic potion from. Yeah, here we go. So, and I did get this cup from World Market. I think it was during Halloween, actually. It was with the Halloween stuff, but I just love this cup. Okay, so I asked the cards, you know, what really happened to him? Where is he? What really happened to him? And I do suspect a woman named, I think it's Kiera. She was the girlfriend of the roommate that Justin was living with. There was a roommate named Bud. And he was living with them. They worked at the same place. They've known each other since childhood, is what I got from the 5-minute clip I watched. But there was a girl named Kiera that was Bud's girlfriend. Okay, and that's what the most I got from that story. So, in fact, I already know what happened to this kid. But we're going to ask the cards, okay? Forgive my nails because I haven't really done them this morning. So, we're just not going to worry about that. All right, so I asked, you know, the cards, let's pick up his energy. So this is the energy I got from him. This is the 9 of Wands. This is a person that feels like they have to defend themselves, okay? You can see that he's been in a battle, that he's wearing a scarf or a bandage on his head right there. Look at his face. He looks worried. He's looking back and forth or over his shoulder to make sure the enemy's not coming. He's thinking a lot about this, and this is what he's defending back here. He's kind of tired, and he's leaning on this pole. He's using the support of this pole to help him, you know, hold himself up. But he's defending what's important to him, which are these poles in the back, wands represent. Okay, so I feel like this is how he felt when he was staying with his roommate, Bud, because of Kiera. I feel like they didn't like each other. I did hear in the clip that she said she didn't like him or something like that. I can't even remember what the clip was about. But I feel like she was extremely jealous of him and that she would pick on him. She didn't want him there. She wanted Bud all to herself. So she was jealous of their relationship. Okay, remember, y'all, this is alleged because I am talking about another person. And everything will be in the disclaimer box for that. But I do feel like she was extremely jealous of the relationship. She didn't want him there. So while he was there, she would pick on him constantly. So I feel like he would have to defend himself. I feel like they Spirit is saying that they would bicker back and forth, but she was doing most of the picking and he was just defending himself. She didn't want him there. She wanted him to leave. Very jealous of the relationship. I'm hearing that over and over. Very jealous. She wanted him gone. She wanted Bud, the roommate, which was her boyfriend, all to herself. She didn't want to share him with Justin because they were best friends, knew each other from birth, okay? So on the day that he came missing, let me get a drink, y'all, from my drink here. My mouth is dry. So on the day that he went missing, he went home to the shed. He had a shed where he would, I think he had a snowmobile and a couple other things that he would mess around with, his tools and stuff like that. I feel like there was foul play because right underneath this card here, I'm going to get to this one here. This is where the foul play comes in. But this is a card of travel. His travel was not successful because when it's in the upright, the chariot means successful travel. But in the reverse, it means that your travel didn't go well, meaning that when he got there, that's when he met foul play. Okay. He made it to his destination, but something terrible happened to him there. They said that they found that place in a mess, like it was a wrecked up. I'm hearing messed up or wrecked up. There was a scuffle. I'm seeing that there was a scuffle there. There was someone in there waiting for him. They hoodwinked him, sabotaged him. He didn't see it coming. He didn't expect anyone to be in that room, his little shed. I don't know if it was locked or not, but they were in there waiting for him, and he did not see what happened to him coming. I feel like this woman that was jealous of him either hired someone to go beat him up or go do something to him or something to that effect. I feel like she sent someone over there. I don't know if that person knew him or didn't know him, but this person that did this to him knew this girl. And she sent this person over there to harm him. But he, you know, he was a big guy. Justin was a big guy. He was over 6 feet tall, I believe. So he put up a pretty good fight, and that's why the whole area was wrecked. It was messed up. Those things out of place, falling over, because he defended himself. Again, it fell right next to the card of defense and the death card. So I'm going to explain to you what the death card means because it's in the reverse. But I do feel like he put up a pretty good fight. Okay, there might have been two people there fighting with him, maybe two. I'm getting one or two. So I did ask Spirit, I asked the universe if he was gone. And I believe that he is no longer with us. I believe that he is in the spirit world because here is a death card. In the reverse, for him, this is what it means, death. Okay, but it fell in, in the upright, it means death or transformation. But in this case, it means death for him because there was no success here. And then here's where he met foul play. This is the evil person that he met foul play. It comes between this card here. Okay, but why is it in the reverse? Okay, so in the reverse, it represents that although he may be gone, let me move my camera over just a little bit. Although he may be gone, that this is not going to end because there is no rest, there is no peace for him because his body has not been found. Now, he might be, okay, I'm going to say this, he might be just kidnapped somewhere, you know, they got him somewhere, but I don't believe that, okay? There can be two scenarios here, so don't get in the comments say, well, he was found and he's not dead, you were wrong. No, I'm telling you right now, there could be two scenarios. I believe that he's gone. Okay, I believe he's gone because of the death card. But since this card fell in the reverse, I believe that it's not over yet because his body hasn't been found. He wants justice. See, it fell right underneath. Again, the justice card is here, which there is no justice because it's in the reverse. So it's not going to end. He's not at rest. He's not. I don't even think he has ascended yet because he's still earthbound because of the way things happened to him. He's waiting for someone to find him, find his body, if he has passed away. I'm going to say if because I'm getting two scenarios here. He might just be locked away somewhere, but I really don't think so. Okay, moving onward. Now here we have the Five of Swords. This is the person that came in to get him. This is a very sneaky, conniving person. This is the Five of Swords. You see how he's smirking. He's smirking, looking at his opponents walking away. He had a fight with these people, Okay, and these people lost. They threw down their weapons and just walked away because they could not fight this person here, because this person has a lot of power, sneaky power, evil. This is the person that got him. Okay, this is the person that came for him, got him. Okay, so this person, I believe, is a Gemini, Libra, and Aquarius, because that's what I'm getting from this card. I feel like they were waiting there for him in his little shed or shack, wherever his snowmobile was, that little place that they said he tinkered. I heard the word tinker, messing around with tools and stuff like that. You know, I guess that was his hobby. But sorry, my camera's rocking back and forth here. I have to hang on to it. They waited there for him. And they were of equal size, is what I'm hearing. They were of equal size. So they put up a pretty good scuffle, pretty good fight. And that's how the little room that he was in got messed up. I do believe that he lost the battle. I believe that he either fell or they hit him over the head with something, which either knocked him out or possibly made him expire. And then from there, his body was taken away somewhere. I'm hearing taken away. I don't know if there's near water, because there's water in the background. So, and it's not smooth. It's very, very unsmooth, unsteady. Sorry, my camera's not focusing. So I do believe that they took him near water, or maybe put him in the water. Okay, so I'm hearing maybe two people were there. This person had another person helping him. Okay. I don't feel like Justin's at rest if he's passed away. I do believe he's passed away. I don't feel like he's at rest. His soul is still here because he wants justice and he wants to be found. He won't ascend until this is solved. All this is coming to me, y'all. All this is coming to me from spirit. Okay. He won't be at rest until he is found. His body is found or something like that. But when this person was waiting for him, oh God, my camera keeps slipping. Then he met foul play. This is what happened. This is the unexpected event, the tower moment. He had a tower moment, unexpected event. It was like this for him. Boom. Okay, they were waiting for him. He walked in. Boom. He had a tower moment. Look at the lightning bolt striking the people. These people are falling down to their death. They weren't aware of what was coming, and that's how he was. He wasn't aware that anyone was there and that this was going to happen to him. So he had a horrible tower moment then. Okay. Terrible tower moment. I keep hearing that. And where they got him. And all this came from that woman that was extremely jealous. I don't know if she wanted him dead, but I do feel like she sent someone over there to harm him, which resulted in his disappearance or his death. Okay. Yeah. That's what I'm getting from spirit and my cards. Now, here we have the justice in the reverse. Again, I told you there is no justice because he has not been found. Okay, so I didn't ask, will he be found? I just got to this part here and I stopped because there probably is going to be a part two. But it won't be, this card can easily be flipped around to justice, but it won't be until he is found, until the crime is solved. It might be difficult to find him, or if ever, because I kind of feel like they put him in the water, dragged him to the water, or put him in the water or something like that. And you know, once you're in the water, the fish eat you up and you just kind of disappear from that moment on, unless they buried him. I don't believe someone buried him because I don't see any of that here. I don't see any digging or you know, being deep in a hole or anything like that. If they do have him captured somewhere, which I honestly don't believe that. I just don't believe that. I do believe he's expired, y'all. Okay. So, yeah. So, this is the truth, y'all. This is what happened. This woman was extremely jealous of the relationship between him and Bud, which was the roommate, and they were best friends since childhood, is what I understand. I did get the childhood card that flipped over and over, but I didn't pull it. I probably should have pulled that card because there's a significance to it now. So I will be doing a part two, but this, I do believe this is what really happened to him. She was extremely jealous, sent someone to go hurt him. I don't know either to, I think that she wanted to scare him and make him just move out. But in the result of that, there was the scuffle, which led to his demise. All right, y'all. So this is it for now. This is for Justin Evans. I pray that there is justice for this young man, that they do find his body if he is expired, or find him So the family can't rest. The family has no rest right now, but the truth will come out, because as you know, the truth always comes out. No matter what you do in this lifetime, you cannot hide the truth. Even if it takes 20 years later, the truth does come out at some point or the other. You can't hide the truth, okay? You just can't. That's God's law, all right? So thanks for watching, y'all. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. If you want a personal reading, contact me with the information down below. I am going to say this. If you make an appointment with me, book a reading, and you miss it, you don't get a refund and you don't get your money back, okay? And I don't reschedule because my time is valuable and I got a lot of people waiting. I had to wait on people like an hour or two, which put other people behind and makes me lose money and time and, you know, my readings. So think about that before you book a time and date with me. Make sure that you're going to be there on the phone when I call you for your reading, because you don't get a refund, all right? Thanks for watching. See you next time.